Hi everyone, welcome to CNS group of company. Today we'll start solving problems using SDM method. As we discussed in previous videos, we have discussed the basic formulas like how FEM and simply supported by using simply supported beam, what are the standard formulas of maximum bending moments, rotation formulas, and in last video we derived slope deflection derivatives equations. So we'll take a simple continuous beam where support A and support C is fixed and is having in between hinge support. So for portion AB, there is an UDL of 20 kN meter. For BC, it is having central point load of 120 kN. So what is the first step? As we discussed in previous video, the first step is nothing but conditions to be satisfied. Just we'll go on comparing this problem. See, what are the rotations we can get or moments? See, from moment A to B, then moment B to A, then moment B to C, and then moment C to B, and then in the problem they have given I. Clear? So what are the unknowns here? M AB, M CB, M BA, M BC. So what are the conditions to be satisfied? We already know that moment AB will not be equal to zero because it is a fixed end moment. Then same thing, moment C to B will not be equal to zero, whereas moment BA plus or minus of moment BC, that is algebraic sum of moment BA plus moment BC, will be equal to zero. These are the conditions to be satisfied. Then coming to second step, that is finding relative stiffness factors, that is K. So what is the formula? K equals I by L. So what is the I given here? For the both the portions, the I is 1. So K A to B or B to A equals I by L, that is 1 I by 6, that is 0.17 I. Then coming to portion B to C, where I is 1 and length is same 6, so 0.17 I. So what is the next step? Next step is finding out fixed end moments. For that, what we are going to do, we are going to consider each portion as a fixed beam individually, and we'll be calculating fixed end moments. So by considering portion AB, what is portion AB? It, which is having an UDL of 20 kN per meter. So what is F AB, that is fixed end moment from A to B? We are considering it as anti-clockwise, so it will be minus. So what is fixed end moment for an UDL? WL square by 12. So that is 20, that is load, into 6 square by 12, that is minus 60 kN into meter. Coming to B to A, that is we are considering it as a positive, that is clockwise, WL square by 12, that is again 60 kN meter. Coming to portion BC, what is the load we have? We have a load of 120 kN, that is central point load. So if a point load, what is the formula? WL by 8. Again, from B to C, it is anti-clockwise. From C to B, it is clockwise, that is 120 into 6 by 8. 120 into 6 by 8 here, negative, because it is an anti-clockwise, it is a clockwise moment. So what we will just revise step from 1 to 3. That is, first thing is we need to calculate or we need to analyze what are conditions to be satisfied. So as it is a simply supported, as it is a fixed beam, the fixed supports, so AB and CB will not be equal to 0. In between, the algebraic sum of moment BA and moment BC will be equal to 0. Then coming to second step, that is finding out K, that is I by L. And in the third step, what we are doing, we are just considering each portion as an individual fixed beam and calculating BA. Here negative because we are considering the left side support as anti-clockwise and the right side support as clockwise. So the next step is step 4, using we'll apply SDM equations. So here, what is theta here? The rotations. So we know that what is fixed beam? Fixed beam is nothing but a fixed end is nothing but rigid one, where it will not rotate, it will not move horizontal or vertical. So what will be theta A here? Theta A equals 0. Same with this end, theta C equals 0. Whereas the simply supported or hinged support will have a rotation. So if you just have a rotation here, that is theta B, that is theta B is unknown here. So from the problem, what is there? Theta A and theta C equals 0. Then how about settlement? In the problem, settlement is not given, so it is 0. So what happens to this equation? MF AB plus 2E, what was KAB? 0.17I. then what about theta A? That is 0. 2 into 0, 0, plus theta B, this portion will be 0. So what happens? MF AB plus 0.34EI into 0 into theta B. What is MF AB? MF AB is nothing but minus 60. If you substitute this, minus 60 plus 0.34EI theta B. This is equation 1. Similarly, we will apply SDM equation for BA, that is MF BA, that is 60. Then 2E KB, that what is KBA? That is same but 0.17I. Then what about theta B here? We have rotation. We have rotation here. So theta B, what about theta A? Equals 0 and settlement is 0. So what happens? 60 plus 2 into 2, 4, 4 into 0.17, 0.68 EI theta B. This will be equation 2. Then coming to portion BC. So what it will be? MBC. So MBC equals MF BC, that is fixed end moment. What is fixed end moment here? Minus 90. Then 2E, what is KBC? 0.17I. We have theta B, theta C equals 0, settlement equals 0. So it will be minus 90 into 0.68 EI theta B. This is equation 3. Then finally we have moment MCB, that is fixed end moment MCB plus 2 times E case CB, that is 0.17I. What is MFCB? That is 90. Theta C equals 0. Why? Because it is a fixed end, plus we have theta B, settlement equals 0. So what happens? 90 plus 2 into 0.17, that is 0.34 EI theta B. So this will be the 4 equation. What are the? One is MBA, MAB, MBA, MBC and MCB. These are four equations. In the next step, using these equations, we will solve for moments. So coming to next step, after calculating MAB, MBA, MBC and MCB, using equilibrium equations, we'll solve the moments. So for using equilibrium equations, we have three conditions. What are those? As we discussed in the first step, moment at AB is not equal to zero. So if not equal to zero means we can't use this. So I'll write it as not useful. So MCB equals not equal to zero. So with it, we can't use. So we have one equation. What is this? BA plus BC equals to zero. So using this, what are the unknown we have? Only theta B. Theta A is 0, theta C is 0. Using this equation, we find out theta B. So what is this? MA plus MC equals 0. What is MBA? 60 plus 0.68 EI theta B. Then plus what is MBC? That is minus 90 0.68 EI into theta B. If you just simplify it, what we are getting? Theta B equals 22.06 EI. So once we get theta, this is the unknown we have, we'll substitute back in end moments. So what is MAB formula or the equation which we got? Minus 60 plus 0.34 EI theta B. So which was the unknown here? Theta B. We know value of theta B. What is that? 22.06 EI. So EI gets cancels. So 0.34 into 22.6 minus 60, which gives minus 52.499 kilonewton meter. So what was the other condition? Means if you solve, if you algebraically add MBA and MBC, what we need to get? We need to get zero. If we are not getting this as zero, then somewhere we have went wrong with the calculations. So once again, to recheck it, what is BA equation which we got? That was second equation. 60 plus 0.68 EI theta B. So EI gets cancelled. That is 75 kilonewton meter. What about BC here? Minus 90 plus 0.68 EI theta B. EI gets cancelled. If you calculate, we are getting minus 75 kilonewton meter. Here we should just cross check the equation. What is the equation? MBA plus MBC equals 0. That is plus 75 minus 75 equals 0. Once we cross check here, then we can further continue with the problem. If we are not getting here, then we need to check the calculations once again. Then coming to next step, that is finding out BMD. So as we discussed in the last videos, how we going to do the BMD here? We are going to divide negative and positive BMD. Then superposition of both will give the resultant BMD. Coming here for negative BMD, what is negative BMD? There is nothing but whatever the end moments which we got, that is MAB, BA, BC and CB. This is nothing but our negative moments. What about positive moment? So what we are going to do to calculate positive moment is nothing but consider each portion as a simply supported beam. For this loading condition, we are going to calculate maximum bending moment. For the first portion, that is span AB, what is the span? 6 meter. What is the load? 20 kilonewton per meter. So what is the formula for maximum bending moment, which we discussed in second video? That is WL square by 8, which is nothing but 90 kilonewton meter. Coming to BA, what kind of load we have here? We have central point load. If you just calculate, we are getting 180 kilonewton per meter. So once we get negative and positive moment, what is the next step? Next step is to draw the BMD diagram and to find out resultant BMD. So what we have calculated so far? We have calculated negative bending moment, that is at portion, at moment AB, moment BA, BC and CB. So what are the, at support A, that is minus 52.499, at support B, that is minus 75, at support C, that is 97.5. This is what? The negative bending moment. What about positive? For span AB 90 and fan span BC is 180. So we'll draw the BMD diagram now. So what is, first we'll draw negative bending moment diagram. What is at support A? Minus 52.499. Then what about support B? 75. Then at support C, that is 97.5. Now how to join this? Just join an inclined line. So this is nothing but negative bending moment in kilonewton meter. The negative bending moment is with respect to what? The end moments. This is negative bending moment. Now we'll draw positive bending moment. How we calculated it? By considering each portion as a simply supported beam. So for portion AB, what is the load here? UDL. What will be the variation? Variation is parabola. So when we consider, so maximum bending moment occurs at center. So this is parabola. What is this? 90 kilonewton meter. Then what about portion BC, which is having central point load? The variation is a triangular load. So this is 180 kilonewton meter. So this is nothing but positive bending moment. Now what will be the resultant bending moment? As we discussed, it is nothing but superposition of both the negative and positive bending moment. So I am writing the negative bending moment. This is the negative bending moment. Then I'll use black color for the positive bending moment. What was value here? That is 52.499, here 75, and this is 97. So now we are superimposing the positive one. This is 90, and what about this? 180. So whatever the thing which is left, which will be the resultant bending moment diagram, like this will be negative, this is positive, this is negative, positive, negative. So in the next problem we will solve for SFD also. So how to draw the BMD? Once we get end moment, that is negative bending moment diagram and positive bending moment diagram, we consider each support as a simply supported beam, then the superposition of this will give the resultant bending moment. So this gives the resultant bending moment. In the next problem we will do SFD also. So if you do like the video, like, share and subscribe the channel. We will meet in next video. Thank you.